Good morning, YouTube. It's like probably like 1 something in the morning. This video gonna be about just, is it worth it to stay out on holiday loads? I'm gonna talk about this load I got. All right, so this load I got, you know, I picked it up yesterday, which was, today is Sunday. What is today? When you out here so long, you lose track of dates, time. But I picked it up on the 23rd. But it said it's not due to deliver until the 26th. Now, something like that, it was only like 700 and something miles for the total load. If y'all wondering what that noise is, like I told y'all, I drained my tanks yesterday. So usually if you drain your tanks, like when you turn your truck on, you're going to have to recharge the full system. So, let me see. Can y'all see? Yeah, so as y'all can see, my system is not a 420 or 140 PSI, so at least I know for my inside cab test that my warning light is working when it's below 40 PSI or below 20 PSI. So at least I know, that's another for sure way to know if your warning buzzard for your air tanks is working, is when you drain your tanks and then you come in here to recharge, it's making this annoying noise. Because it'll also say 2 on the dash. It'll say, let me see. Yeah, it'll say brake air pressure supply low. And once that it get past the 60, like get out of the red zone, it'll stop. And, you know, it'll go back to normal. But you still can't. Because a lot of times if your brake pressure is low, you can't even push in your valves until the system charge. So that's another for sure way to do your in-cab inspection, is just drain your tanks, and then when you get in here, you know that your dash is working properly. But back to this load. So this load is from the 23rd to the 26th, and it's only going like 700 something miles. It's paying like, I think like $1,300 for the load. Something like that should only be like a 2-day turnover. So, you know, I should have rejected the load now that I think about it. But the main reason I took it, and see, I have my older kids. I don't know if y'all been following my story, but my older kids been getting in trouble and stuff like that, to the point to where they had to stay in North Carolina, because North Carolina's where I used to live before I moved back to Baltimore with my family. So my, you know, that my family could watch my kids while I'm out here on the road. So basically, I'm in between two states to see my older kids and then be with my younger kids. All right, so that's going to come into the story. So, okay, this load is from the 23rd to the 26th, but in my head, I'm like, okay, well, this ain't a Walmart, because, you know, Walmart loads, you have to deliver it either out before the time or on time. You know, you can't be too early at all. But a lot of these places, especially if it's a drop and hook, you can just deliver it early. So I called the receiver yesterday, and just to see if I could, and they told me that they closed today until the 26th. So I have to wait until the 26th to deliver this load that should only take at 2 days minimum to do anyway. So since Georgia ain't too far from North Carolina, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get enough fuel to, because obviously I'm gonna go off route. I don't recommend going off route like that, but in a situation like this where it's the holiday, I'm not about to sit here and go to no freaking receiver and be sitting there for damn near a 34-hour reset looking stupid by myself with me and my damn dog. I want some human beings, and I'm gonna see some of my kids for the holiday. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go see my older kids in North Carolina and spend Christmas with them. So that's what I'm gonna do. I might not be spending it with my little ones, but at least I'm gonna spend it with my older ones. So that's not bad at all. So on Christmas Day, guys, I will not be in this truck, but at least I have a load under my back. And because with Prime, you know, these trucks, you have to rev it after, you know, when it come up on 5 minutes, you gotta rev it so it don't cut off. Matter of fact, my governor did cut off, but I gotta get ready to get fuel. But at the end of the nutshell, because I do gotta get going, because where I'm going is gonna take my whole clock. But what I'm saying is, for the holidays, if you got a load under your back and you got the fuel and the time to go and just probably go close to home that's near the state you're going to, especially if you're a lease now. I don't know about companies, because as a company, you pretty much can't really be going off route like that. You gotta be under their mercy. But as a lease op, we got more freedom with decisions like that. It's just that when you go off route, just be prepared that you're going to, not to say waste money, because time with family is never a waste, but you got to be prepared to spend extra money for those extra miles of going off route. But hey, in this situation, I should have just freaking went home for the holidays. And, you know, I don't really, shoot, dealing, being under a load this long for that amount of money, that's going to give me a short week next week, and I don't appreciate that. So I'll talk more on this topic, but I got to hurry up and get fuel so I can get going so that I can enjoy. At least I'll do my 34-hour reset with my older boy. So bump that crap, man, shoot. If I would have known that, I would have rejected it, or at least got them to run me through Baltimore instead of some damn on the east-south region. So it's all good, though. At least I get to see one set of my kids, you know. All right, y'all. I'll be getting back with y'all. Let's love each other, not judge each other. So I'll be getting back with y'all. Time is of the essence. Let me get some time, get this fuel, and get down the road. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year's.